So, again, property taxes is not something that people want to do, but we believe that this proposed bond referendum is, for referendum, is the kinds of investment in those kinds of critical communities that we can, we believe can make a difference. Let's see if there are other things to emphasize. A couple of other things, if you, again, look at this table on the inside. I'm just going to kind of go down the list here for a second, and then I'll stop and see if there are any questions. I don't know how much time I have or that kind of thing. You tell me.
You have a little time.
Still got some time, okay. And then I'm going to obviously defer to my council member colleagues, not colleagues, council member.
Colleagues.
No, colleagues. Sorry. To see if there's anything we want to add. So Airport West Corridor, those are for road improvements out past the airport. You may have heard about the intermodal facility out there, large train investment that's occurring out there. If we are able to build and extend some roads out in that area, we believe that can leverage up to 5,000 jobs. It's a jobs generator connection for that.
What do you mean?
Yeah, that's a big deal. East-Southeast Corridor, that's Independence. Rest assured, $92 million does not fix Independence Corridor. So let's just be real clear about that. That's a large scale project on a big level. But these things, such as the Monroe Road streetscape, Ottawa Road, Monroe Road intersection, those kinds of intersections and streetscapes can help turn Independence from fronting what will eventually be a freeway towards the neighborhood on the backside, which is Monroe Road, and face the neighborhoods that way. It's a conversion of Independence Boulevard. This starts that process. Northeast Corridor, you've heard about the Blue Line extension with light rail. These are investments associated with creating connections, such as these two bridge improvements, which can leverage jobs at the university, as well as neighborhood connections to the Blue Line. That creates property tax, private sector investment, which then raises the tax value in all the areas of the city and helps balance who pays. The connection, the road projects are straightforward. Prosperity Church Road is a connection associated with I-85 interchange, so that as I-85 is completed, the traffic coming off of I-485 doesn't get backed up because it can't get off the interchange. I mentioned the Charlotte Multi-Use Trail, streetcar extension. Let me be more clear about the streetcar. That doesn't do the entire segment. This proposal does from about French Street, just on the other side of Johnson C. Smith, through the uptown to right at about the hospital at Hawthorne, Sunnyside, which is a street just past there. Future segments would have to be built later. Sidewalks and pedestrian safety. This is just more sidewalks, particularly in those areas that have safety issues. Traffic control and bridges, public safety facilities. We're proposing a joint communication center with police and fire 911, as well as 311. It's a consolidation of our communications equipment and can create some savings and efficiencies for us. Six proposed police stations. This is in addition to the police stations like the one at Metro in other areas of the city. And then affordable housing and the Comprehensive Neighborhood Improvement Program. So that's our proposed plan. Let's see if there's anything else I want to mention. Oh, sorry, two more things, then I'll stop. In this PowerPoint handout, did everybody get one? Okay. I just wanted to indicate this bar chart on the front. The blue bars indicate the bond referendums that have occurred in the past. The gold represent what we're proposing. If we don't do the proposed tax increase, we can't do these bond referendums. Meaning, we can't release and sell more debt in order to make that kind of capital investment.
Say that again, please.
If we don't do the proposed tax increase, we can't do these bond referendums. So, if we could figure out a way to do these referendums without tax increase, we would certainly do that. But because of the economy and our revenue stream, we're not able to. The other thing is, if you flip on the inside, in terms of the process, we are right in the middle of the process. This process for the staff started actually back last July. We had a robust conversation with the council at your February, at their February retreat. And now we're to the part of the public hearing. Public hearing is actually tonight at 7 o'clock in the government center. And tomorrow is the council's adjustments process, where they vote to make changes to the budget that they may wish to do. And then June 11th is the adoption. That contact information slide, charlottefuture.com has got a whole bunch of information on it for those of you that like to look at maps and get really into the details.